Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you polar plot for given open loop transfer function, where open loop transfer function is given by s cube divided by s plus 1, s plus 2. So we will plot polar plot for this open loop transfer function step by step. So let us have a first step in that we are dealt with to place s is equals to j omega. So now we will place s is equals to j omega in this open loop transfer function. So we'll be having g of j omega that is equals to j omega cube divided by 1 plus j omega 2 plus j omega. Now once we have this system in terms of g omega, we need to write this equation in standard form of polar plot. So let me write that in terms of standard form of polar plot. That is our second step. So standard form of polar plot, that is magnitude of system into phase of system. So here you see magnitude of this, that is on numerator it is omega cube. And in denominator, you see square root of real component square plus imaginary component square. So this is 1 plus omega square. And this is again square root of 2 square, that is 4 plus omega square. Right. So this is magnitude. Now when we talk about phase, then we can have phase as per poles and zeros. For zeros means for numerator, angle will be positive, and for denominator means for poles, angle will be negative. And angle will be tan inverse imaginary component divided by real component. So you see here in numerator at omega is equals to 0, there are 3 zeros, right? What it means, for 1 0, angle is 90 degree. How it is happening? Tan inverse imaginary divided by real. Imaginary is omega, real is 0, so tan inverse 0, tan inverse omega by 0, so tan inverse infinite, which is 90 degree. And for three zeros, 90 plus 90 plus 90 means plus 270 degree angle is there. Now for denominator, angle is negative, so minus tan inverse imaginary, that is omega, divided by real, that is 1, so tan inverse omega, again pole is there, means minus tan inverse omega divided by 2. So that is how magnitude and phase that we have for this particular system. Now in third step, we are dealt with to identify magnitude and phase for this polar plot at omega is equals to 0 and at omega is equals to infinite. So let us find this coordinate at omega is equals to 0 first. So at omega is equals to 0, if we see magnitude g of j omega, then just place omega is equals to 0. So 0 divided by anything, so that is 0 only. And if you see phase, so here phase is 270 minus 0 minus 0, so that is 270. And as if you consider very important point, that is omega is equals to infinite, so in that let us calculate g of j omega. So you see in numerator omega raised to 3 is there, right? And in denominator, if you take omega and omega common, right, so in that case, in numerator there will be omega and in the denominator there will be 1 plus 1 by omega square in square root, and in another square root 1 plus 4 by omega square. So that will be having infinite in numerator. So we can say magnitude is infinite for this particular case. And if you calculate phase of g omega, then you see 270. And then omega is equals to infinite means minus 90 and another minus 90. So 270 minus 90 minus 90. So that will be 90 degree. So now we have these two important points. Now to have polar plot, we are dealt with to have separation of real and imaginary part, right? So now our next step is to separate real and imaginary part. Now to separate real and imaginary part, all we need to do is we need to multiply complex conjugate of denominator with this, then we can separate real and imaginary part. And why do we separate this real and imaginary part? The reason is, in polar plot we are dealt with to identify intersection to real axis and intersection to imaginary axis, right? So by multiplying and dividing complex conjugate of denominator, we can separate real and imaginary part. So let us do that. Now as if you do this, then what will happen? You see, in denominator we'll be having 1 minus j square omega square. J square is minus 1, so this will be 1 plus omega square, and this will be 2 square minus j square omega square. So j square is minus 1, so that will be 4 plus omega square, right? Now in numerator, j omega cube, that is there with us. Now let us do this multiplication and then we will separate real and imaginary. So see, 1 into 2, so that is 2. Now you see, minus into minus plus, j square is minus 1, and omega into omega, omega square. So this will be minus omega square. Now you see, 2 into minus j omega and 1 into minus j omega, addition, so that is minus 3 j omega. Now let us separate these terms. Now let us re-simplify this. So this is minus 3 omega raised to 4 divided by 1 plus omega square, 4 plus omega square, that is real part, and then plus j into, if I write plus j, then here omega cube into omega square minus 2, that is there in numerator, divided by 1 plus omega square, 4 plus omega square, that is how separation is there with real and imaginary part. So now we have all the points which we are dealt with to have it to have polar form, right? So here all we can do is, now we can identify intersection to real and intersection to imaginary axis. So intersection to real axis, that happens when imaginary component is zero, right? So if you provide intersection to real axis, right, in that case you will have to compare imaginary component. So that is this component, that is equals to zero. So in that case, here you can clearly see there are two possibilities, omega is equals to zero, and another possibility is omega square is equals to 2. So omega is equals to square root of 2 radian per second. So that is where we have intersection to real axis. Now to have intersection to imaginary axis, we need to compare this real component is equals to 0. So if you compare this with 0, you can have only one point, that is omega is equals to 0. So now we have all the points covered over here with this polar plot calculation. So let us plot polar plot here, right? And we will place all those data step by step. And I have seen one question of student, he was telling me like, sir, how to define a shape of polar plot, right? So you just see how I am defining shape of polar plot, right? So here we have a real axis and this is imaginary axis, and this is center, which is origin, right? Now here, first of all, we should have basic idea about two important points. At omega is equals to 0, magnitude is 0 and angle is 270 degree, right? So in polar plot, one should know here angle is 0, here angle is 90 degree, here angle is 180 degree, and here angle is 270 degree, and this is what? Positive angles. Sometimes you will be having negative angles. So here it will be minus 270 degree, here it will be minus 180 degree, here it will be minus 90 degree, and here it is 0, right? So angles may be they're positive, angles may be they're negative. You will have to consider as per these notations which I have given over here. And as I have said, first point, that is at omega is equals to 0, magnitude is 0 and phase is 270, right? So 270 positive means here you can observe that is the phase by which it is coming, right? At 270, and magnitude is 0. So over here we have omega is equals to 0 with phase is equals to 270, right? So from here it will enter. Now second point, that is at omega is equals to infinite, magnitude is infinite and angle is 90. So angle is 90 over here, right? And it is happening at infinite magnitude, means radius is infinite, that one should consider. So if I say at very long distance, it is happening somewhere over here. So here we have omega is equals to infinite and phase phi is equals to 90 degree. Now you see intersection to real and imaginary, that is what we have calculated. So intersection to real, that happens at omega is equals to square root of 2, right? And as if omega is equals to square root of 2, we can have magnitude calculation, right? And that magnitude that we need to calculate, g of j omega at omega is equals to square root of 2, right? So if you place this omega is equals to square root of 2 in this, then you will be getting magnitude, and here this magnitude, that is 0.66, right? You just see how I have calculated, that is 0.66. So I'm just placing this magnitude 0.66, and as if this magnitude is 0.66, you'll have to find angle also. So phi at omega is equals to square root of 2. So if you calculate this angle, you see how it is happening. It is 270 minus 30 minus 60. So that is 180 degree. So this angle is 180 degree. So intersection to real happens at magnitude 0.66 and phase of 180 degree, right? So let us say that is somewhere over here, and that is having this magnitude, that is 0.66, right? And that is happening at omega is equals to square root of 2 and phase, that is 180 degree, right? Now you see graph that will begin from omega is equals to 0, right? And it will go towards omega is equals to infinite. So you see that is how it is beginning, and it is going towards omega is equals to infinite. So this is how polar plot is getting plotted for given transfer function. I hope you have understood this. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any queries, you just place that in comments. Definitely I'll try to get back to you. And based on your queries, in future I'll be making videos which will resolve your understanding. Thank you so much for watching this video.